Hello friends, welcome to another video tutorial of SolidWorks. In this video tutorial, we will be learning how to create isometric thread screw in SolidWorks. You might have seen many video tutorials on YouTube in which many people tell you how to create screw or bolt in SolidWorks, or even in CATIA, AutoCAD or any CAD software, but nearly all of them uses a random profile, which is not the real case. In real case, we have some specific standards, specific charts, specific drawings, profiles we have to use to create these kind of threads. We cannot just randomly assume. Like in one video tutorial I saw, a person was using a circle and as a profile and used swept cut command to create the profile, and which that is never the case in industry. In industry, everything is driven by standards. You might have seen many kind of. You might have even heard about many standards like ISO, DIN, DIN is for Germany, GIS, Japanese, American ASI, these kind of standards you might have heard. Even India has a standard that is IS, so Indian standard. So everybody has to always keep in mind these standards while creating these screws, etc. Like every bolt and nut and every screw is actually governed by these standards. You might have heard about design data books for mechanical engineers. Like, let me show you. I'm using this design data handbook from PSG College of Technology, Coimbatore, India. This book had nearly all the data I needed, even in my industrial work. When I was working in industry and I had to look up some data for any kind of design, this book was always with me and it was very helpful for me. So for today, I'm also referring you to this book that I'm using. You can get all the data I'm using in this book or in any design data handbook, like in R.K. Mahadevan or any big writer or any trusted source. Okay, you don't just go randomly on internet and use any data available. That is not the case in these kind of design. In this design, there are very careful standards we have to follow very carefully. Okay, like every dimension, even the chamfer is governed by these standards. Yeah, I know in industry, when you go in market to buy these screws, many of them are not as per standard. There are screws which are even eccentric. This is because those industries have very poor quality control. But as a designer, you should always keep in mind that if the design is wrong, the production will always go wrong. Okay, so let me show you the thread profile. So this is the thread profile we have to use. Okay, we cannot use any random circle or random polygon or any arc or any square, anything. We cannot just use it randomly. There is a square thread profile also, but I am not going to use that. I am going to use thread profile ISO metric in that case. Okay, this one we are going to use this profile in this video tutorial, and we will be creating the model based on this. Okay, let me show you the charts for this. For example, you can see that this is the pitch. Okay, let me open the this is the Wikipedia page here. Okay, as you can see that I'm designations for metric screws, that means millimeters. Okay, that means M6 screw has a nominal outer diameter of 6 mm. That means if you measure M6 screw the maximum dia, it will be around 6 mm. It is not actually the case in, you will always get it like 5.95, 5.9 or something, but it is nearly 6 mm. Okay, so you can see that this is the basic profile for all isometric screw threads. Okay, the lower one is our screw, the upper one is our nut. Okay, nuts have the internal thread and bolt and screws have the external threads. Okay, this is the profile we will be using. Okay, for example, this height is actually, there is a formula for that, h is equal to 1 by 2 tangent theta, or you can say equivalent to 0.866 into pitch. Okay, this is the formula. For example, we, in this video tutorial, we will be modeling a M8 screw. M8 means, let me show you, M8 means 8 mm. For ISO 262 means the pitch will be around, coarse pitch will be 1.25, fine will be 1. We are going to use the chorus. Okay, 1.25. You can even see here, we have more data here. For example, M8 in case of socket head cap screw. Socket head cap screw is ISO 4762. That is mostly used in industry. That is used a lot. It is also known as Allen screw. You might have heard Allen screw because there is a Allen key here, slot here. So the Allen key size will be 6 mm for M8. Okay, in case of a grub screw, it changes to 4. Okay, so these are basic standards we have to follow. In case of M8, the ISO hex nut, okay, 13. The, you know, this distance from this line to this line. In Dutch, in German, Deutsch international nomenclature, in German standard, it is also 13. The standards German or Indian or ISO runs nearly the same. There are very only few changes. Okay, very minute changes. Like here you can see that 16 becomes 17. 18 become 19, but here ISO has 34, but DIN has 32. Okay, so in this video tutorial, we will be creating a model for M8. M8 means metric 8 screw. Okay, you can see this profile here, but we need also the data. Okay, I have noted down the data from my design handbook. You can see here that for M8, 1.25 will be the pitch, the major diameter will be 8, it will be around 7.9 if you measure it. The pitch diameter will be 7.188, minor diameter will be 6.466. in case of bolt, in case of nut, it will change 6.647. depth of thread will be 0.767. maximum depth of engagement will be 0.677 and stress area will be 36.6 newton per millimeter square. Okay, so let's first talk about these parameters. Okay, size, pitch, etc. So I will open this one. Okay, as you can see that pitch is the distance between two consecutive thread. Okay, major diameter will be the diameter you can measure when you measure it with a vernier caliper, measure the shaft of the, okay, the threaded shaft of the screw. Okay, this will be the major diameter. Okay, it will be, for example, that's why I told you that it will never be M8, because there is some kind of clearance here. You can see that. Okay, this is not exactly here. Let me show you in this. Okay, this is not here sharp. If you measure it till this point from the shaft to center line or from other end, it will be exactly 8 mm, but you cannot keep these sharp points, so that's why there is a clearance here, MH by 8. Also because we have to decrease the depth of engagement, because this we cannot create a sharp cavity inside the nut also. So there is some kind of recess here, some gap here. That's why there is a H by 8 here, okay, the gap. Okay, that so the major diameter is not actually 8 mm, it is little less than 8, or you can say that M8, or you can say the size you wanted, like if you wanted M12, so it will be M12 minus H by 8 minus H by 8, and H is 0.866 P, and P is the pitch you can get from here, which is 1.754 M12. Okay, so this is how you calculate it. Okay, let me show you again this. Okay, so minor diameter will be the minimum diameter in this case. Okay, this is the angle here, 30 degree, this is 60 30. Okay, this is actually a equilateral triangle, that's why there is 60 degree. Okay, so let's move to modeling part. Okay, so I will start SolidWorks now. Okay, first I have to tell you that we are going to use some kind of equations in this video tutorial. We can do it manually also, but to save some trouble for calculations, I am going to use equations here. So I will go to Tools, Equations. As I mentioned earlier, we are going to model a M8 screw, Allen screw, which is ISO 4762. So for that, the diameter we want is, the size is 8 mm. This is not the major diameter, this is the actual size of the screw, okay, that we usually say. Okay, and the pitch is 1.25. this comes from chart, let me show you. M8 has a pitch of 1.25. okay, so let's keep it like that. Okay, now height will be, let's open the Wikipedia page. You can see that height is 1 upon 2 tangent theta into P, or you can say root 3 by 2 into P, or nearly equivalent to 0.866 P. We can directly use this value, 0.866 P. so I will just write down pitch into 0.866. I press tab key, and now this is written here. Okay, I will just click OK. I'm not going to input major diameter, minor diameter here, because it will just increase our calculations. I am going to use minimum equations so that it will be the easiest to understand. So let's click OK. So now right plane, sketch, circle. We are going to create the shaft first. Okay, for the diameter. Okay, keep in mind that we have to keep in mind some things. Okay, let me show you. We are not going to create the circle for this diameter here, we are going to create this here. Okay, for this diameter here. Okay, or we can just do it very easy way. Okay, let me do it more easily. Let's just draw a center line here. Okay, like this. So this is our axis of the screw. Okay, let's draw a line here first, something like this. Draw another line here. Okay, assume this as the minimum diameter. Okay, as the minor diameter. Okay, now the line is for pitch diameter. Now we will draw major diameter. Okay, okay, now let's draw a vertical line here. This is for our pitch. Okay, now smart dimension, select both of these, click here, press equal key, and now global variables, pitch. Okay, you can see that there is a summation symbol in front of that. That means it is driven by equations. You can here see that. Okay, now we have to draw the major, minor, all these axes. Okay, let's go back to our thread profile here. Okay, so here height h. So first let's draw this line here. This is the diameter. Okay, I will draw this also here. Select this center line and this point here and equal global variables diameter. Okay, okay, this is our maximum diameter here. This is not going to be real, but we are going to use this for construction. Okay, now the height. Okay, the height is around at h. Okay, so we are going to draw another line here. Okay, like this, and now the distance between these, press equal key, global variables, height, click OK. Okay, let's move these lines here, because these lines actually belong here. Okay, okay, now we will draw these here. Okay, the difference between this and this line, that means the diameter line and major diameter line, is around h by 8. Okay, so I will just write down here like this and press equal key, global variables, height, now divide by 8, click OK. So we don't use divide symbol, so I used oblique key here. Okay, so here is our 0.14. just let's make this up to 3 digits. Okay, so we have created this here. Now we will find the distance for pitch dia. Okay, for pitch dia it is 3 into h divided by 8. Okay, press equal key, global variables, height into, let's check it again. This is very important step. Don't make it 4 or 5, because that will ruin your whole design. In the end, our angle should be 60 degree here. So 3 into h by 8 into 3 divided by 8. Okay, so this is for our pitch. Okay, now for the third profile, the minor diameter is at 5 into h by 8. Okay, let's check it again from the major diameter. Okay, is equal to global variables into 5 divided by 8. Now click OK. Now we will use the dimensions here. I will just click here till here and put it here, make this dimension driven. Okay, select this and select this, write down major diameter. Now write down here pitch diameter. This is for your better understanding here. Okay, so these are all our construction lines we needed. Okay, so now we have to come to directly to the construction part. Okay, so we have to draw these lines here. Okay, so I will just, this is now very easy. Now you don't have to look at the standards if you know how to do it perfectly. Okay, distance between this and this is going to be pitch divided by 2. Okay, let's measure the angle. You can see it is 60 degree. It is not actually 60, but there is an error of third decimal place, so that is not going to be counted here. Okay, and that is also because in our equation we didn't use 1 by 2 tangent theta into p. Okay, we used the direct integer value here, 0.866. okay, if we would have used that direct 1 by 2 tangent theta into p, it would have been more easier. Okay, okay, let's click okay. So you can see that we constructed our profile here. Okay, but if you will measure that, you will get exactly these dimensions. Okay, exactly these dimensions. Now I will draw a line here like this, a line here, a line here. Okay, so this is our profile here. Okay, you can see, click exit sketch here. Now again sketch on right plane. Now convert this, select this sketch one here, click on convert, because we don't need the whole profile here. Okay, we only need this here. Okay, okay, now front plane, sketch a circle and be sure that this circle is actually coincident on this point. Okay, on our minor diameter. Now extrude it 40 mm. Now we have to create a helix. Let's hide this here. Sketch on this face. Click on convert entities. It doesn't matter the diameter of helix. The pitch does matter, but okay. Go to features. curves, helix and spiral. Reverse the direction. The pitch is 1.25. Okay. Change it to height and pitch. Height is, let's say, if the total length is 40, I will make it around 45. Okay. Start angle, keep it 0. Okay. Click on OK. Now go to one more thing in this helix. Always keep it clockwise here. Okay. Swept boss. Select this as profile. Select this helix. Okay. Click on OK. Now hide this helix. Now select this face, sketch, draw a circle very bigger than this, okay? Something like this. Extrude cut. That is actually thickness error, zero thickness error. That is the worst error you can get in SolidWorks. Okay. For this face, we will directly make a hexagon. Okay. Now, since we are going to make it ISO 4762, we will now be using this profile here. Okay. You can see that we have some standards for this also, like the outer diameter will be based on the these charts here. Okay. For M8, it is going to be between, nominal is around 13 mm, but minimum is 12.73. so this diameter for the hex key should never be less than 12.73. okay, if some company is making it around 12.5, it is automatically failed in ISO standards. Okay, the Allen key size here is S. Okay, let's check it. 6 mm here. Okay, nominal, but maximum is 6.15, so that there is some clearance for the spanner. Minimum is 6.03. okay. Max 4.78 4.3. this is the depth for the our slot for the hexagonal Allen key. Okay, and the threaded length, usually it is around 28 mm if you are going for long screws like M8 into 40. In that, only 28 will be threaded. If you don't go for specific, you can also get threaded 40 mm, but mostly 28 mm is threaded here. Okay, this X here is the chamfer. We are not going to use it because we have created a hole threaded, okay, whole length threaded screw. Okay, this Z here is the chamfer here. This is around let's see, M8, it is around 1.25. okay, the radius here, okay, it is just suitably radiused. It will be around 1 mm or something. Okay, so let's create our hexagon here.
I will just draw a circle here. Diameter should be 13 mm. The value of K in our chart is 6 mm, sorry, 8 mm. Okay. So extrude it 8 mm. The main reason for that, let's fix it. Okay. Edit this. Let's make it complete. Okay. Now extrude cut, reverse. Okay. Now everything will work. Okay. The value of K is 8 mm. In our chart, okay. The value of T, maximum is 4.78, minimum is 4.3. We are going to assume 4.5 here, okay. And the spanner key size S is 6 mm, okay. 6.15. Let's use the maximum value. Select this face, sketch. Six point 1.5. Make this vertical, okay. Extrude cut 4.5. For this depth here, we can just select this face, sketch, convert entities, features, extrude it, cut, okay, draft, let's say 45 degree, okay. Just have to use some random value here, okay. Okay. Now here radius, let's assume 1 mm. Okay. Now we have to create a chamfer for here, okay. So let's first see the value again. For Z, the value for M8 is 1.25, okay. Top plane, sketch, normal 2, okay. Select this line, convert entities, okay. Select the origin and this line here, this point, 4 mm. Okay. Let's make these equal. Okay, this is center line. For the axis of cut, make a revolve cut. Okay, so here is the cut, okay. Now let's see if we missed anything. This X we are not going to use because we are creating a whole length screw here, okay? In case of our thread profile, okay. So friends, in this video tutorial we created a M8 ISO 4762 hexagon socket head cap screw, also known as Allen screw, in SolidWorks. Okay, let's measure some dimension here. You cannot measure here the diameter, okay, but it is going to be the same as in our standards. Okay, so friends, in next video I will be creating the nut for this screw here, okay. So till then, if you like this video, click on like and share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel, and if you click on bell icon you will receive all the updates from this channel. And in future I am going to upload more such mechanical things on my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video tutorial and have a nice day.